I drove a newborn baby home from the hospital on her very first car ride. Balloons blocking the rear view the whole time. I've dealt with drunken misogynists and homophobes who are proud of their ignorance. Had long conversations with queer women of color about the importance and the nature of poetry. I've been a driver for drug deals, chauffeur to strip clubs, gamblers at the casino who had one big, some who lost it all. I've been stiffed by stuffy businessmen who discussed their new accounts on the way to the airport. I've been tipped well by a waitress, getting off the late shift, working paycheck to feed her kids. You're only as healthy, you're only as healthy, you're only as healthy as you feel. I picked up a woman in Mount Washington being comforted by her mother. She said, They shot my brother. Oh God, they shot my brother. I drove her to Hazelwood in relative silence, besides a prayer or a whimper from time to time. We arrived on the scene. There were police cars and a news team. She said, how much do I owe ya? I said, of course, don't worry about it. I don't know what else to say. I'm sorry. She opened up the door, stepped out of the cab, and in the loving arms of a neighbor, she collapsed. There's no escape, there's no escape. I'm God's lonely man. A little girl and her mom had forgotten something vital when they flew to the big city for the big ballet recital. Unpacking her luggage at the hotel, and then it hit her. She forgot to pack her ballet slippers. They called all around the town, searching for the perfect pair. Real Cinderella story, she was getting real worried. To the place on 51, they saved the day. But wait, there's more. It was closing time for the store, so they entrusted those shoes behind the counter with some dude at the gas station next door. So off we went, they were thanking me, I was thanking them. Mission complete. The girl was so happy, the mom was so relieved. It's where the story ends for me, but not for them. Are you talking to me? Are you talking to me? No one else here, you must be talking to me. Picked up an old woman at the hospital, dealing with chronic pain. She was cranky and mean along the way. Tried to start some small talk, asked if she liked that ice cream spot. There on the corner, there's always a big line, you know, so I figure it must be pretty good. She said, ice cream is ice cream. I don't see the big deal. We pulled up to her house and she handed me two $20 bills. I said, ma'am, you've made a mistake. You gave me two $20 bills. She said, no, that's for you. Thanks for the ride. She struggled to get out of the taxi. She struggled to get up her stairs. I asked if she'd like some help. She said, I can do this myself. Then she began to weep. Quiet and soft. I got another call, so I drove off.